most of us have experience interacting with LLM AI language models like ChatGPT. However, when you engage with this model, you engage with monolithic system. If you aim to use such a model for production in business use cases, you need to break that monolith and you cannot speak only with LLM. You need to add a lot of components to that LLM, and that components include, for example, guard lace, vector search, agents and functions. And today we will speak mainly about agents and function, because we will explore how to deploy agents, and that agent, by using function, will enable LLM to talk to your data and to interact with your data, or even do actions outside of your data to perform custom REST API calls, for example, to make the order. In our example, the data model, which LLM will interact with, is related to X production. It is Henhouse, which we manage, and we want to use chat to, for example, to determine if we have, for example, enough eggs for tomorrow to perform order, or to know how many eggs are available right now. And thanks to that functions, because we will have three function, model will know details about our data. And what is the most important here is that metadata is crucial, because your model will be only as good as your data is, and your model will read metadata about your data to interact with your data. So it's really important, for example, to define primary keys, to define foreign keys, to have meaningful field names, to have comments and description for every table, every field, and every function, and every parameter which you can pass to that function. So everything need to be well designed, and after that, the model will be able to talk to your data and perform action. So let's see in practice how we will do that. Let's take a look to our model. Here in that notebook, we are creating that model. We are creating all tables and are inputting example data needed for that table. So we have a table with egg types, with inventory, with forecast. We are inputting some recalls with orders. And then we have a function for LLM to interact with that data. What is important here is documentation. As I mentioned, there are comments, so everything is well described. And also we have names of the eggs, so for example, chicken eggs, but it's a language model, so we need to look for something similar, because maybe it will be spelled by a model differently or a bit differently. So inside of that function used by LLM, we are using another LLM function, which is AI similarity, and it's supported by Databricks. And this way we are finding the most similar X to our use case. So here are another functions, and here we can see that our data is deployed. So we have tables, we have our function like get available X. And I will include a link to that functions and table in description below. And what we will do now, we can go to Playground. And here, when we are using Meta Llama model in tools, we can include that function. Functions. So let's take a look and include everything from Egg Shop. So we are adding that functions to the model, and it's always good to add system prompt for our model that our model will know that needs to interact with that data. So let's type use functions to interact with questions about X hen house. One of important tasks is that system prompt usually we need to polish based on feedback from interactions with model to perform better. But let's put it now as simple as it is. Save it and start asking questions. So first question will be how many chicken eggs do I have? We see that it is using function, and we see what parameter had been passed to that function, and it's because of similarity it returned also duck egg, but model know that we are asking about chicken eggs and is giving correct answer. You have 500 chicken eggs available. So let's ask how many eggs we will have tomorrow. It is executing correctly, get forecast availability, and we got correct information that 420 eggs will be available tomorrow. So that LLM, thanks to that function, knows your data. But now it's next step that we need to deploy this to production, and we don't want to our end user, for example, to see that functions and use playground. So it's really easy, because what we need to do, we need to just click export. But here are a few important things to note. First of all, if we look to files, there is config file. And here is really important that we specify function which are passed to our model. In that example, everything, but maybe in real life you will not pass everything. And we specify here also SQL warehouse, and that ID is used to interact with our data because we need to perform selects or invoke functions on SQL warehouse. So we need to specify that ID, and probably in CI/CD process to production, we'll need to update it. That driver notebook is notebook which we are using to deploy our model. Here, that notebook is installing LangChain libraries. Here are some evaluation examples. This is something which we are using to test our model. We can put expected response here. But what is the most important here is that we are registering that model to Unity Catalog, and it's also registering the feedback app. And what we need to update here, we need to put model name and schema. So our schema is eggshop, and model name will be eggchat. Okay. Here we are creating serving endpoint, which will serve our model. So people can interact with that model not only by using Databricks workspace, but they can also use REST API, for example. So we can deploy a custom chat app to interact with that model. And here with this agents deployed, we are registering that serving endpoint. But what I found here missing is ability to scale to zero. So we will not pay when our model is not used. Actually, when we go through UI to models and serve that model, there is this option scale to zero. But I prefer to register this way the model, because first it's as a code, so it can be repeated easily. And second, also that function agent deploy is creating automatically feedback model which is really useful, and I will show you in seconds. So let's run all of that and register that model and create serving endpoint. It will take a few minutes, so I will pause video and get back to you once it's done. Our model is registered, and successfully we've created version first of the model. Deployment process of serving endpoint has started. So let's take a look first at model. We will refresh our Unity catalog, and we can see that two models were deployed. As I mentioned, one is XChat, and another is feedback model, which will allow to gather feedback regarding the model. Then in serving endpoints, we can see that there is new serving endpoint, which is specifically set to serve that model. So it's like separate compute. We've set it as a small compute with scale to zero. Also, we've enabled, it was automatically enabled, in fact, inference table. So all interactions to that logger, to that model, will be locked to that table. After that, we can import that interaction and validate. And based on that, we can gather feedback regarding our model. Now, let's wait a few minutes because we need our and serving endpoint to be ready, and then we can start to use it and query. Our agent is finally deployed, and now we have multiple options here. We have possibility to review the app. We can again try that app in playground, that model in playground, or we can just query. Here we can send a test request. In fact, our external app probably will use this way by sending JSON through REST API call to interact with our model. So let's send request, and we can see response that we have 500 chicken eggs available. We can also use Python client to interact with our model. We can use SQL AI query function. But whatever model you choose to interact with that model, all that question are locked into inference table. And let's take a look to it. Let's find that schema in catalog and see what is in that inference tables. So all our interaction with model is logged in XChat payload table. And we can see here that all of our question, which I was sending to model, how many eggs do we have, everything is logged here. And then it's possible to import that data and review that in review app. So let's select some example data. Let's import some of this request IDs to our review app, and let's validate is question and answer correct. So let's copy the first ID. And there is a function agent enabled trace reviews to import that IDs. And let's copy one more ID. So let's import that two IDs using Databricks agent library. First, we need to install that library and then import that IDs. From log, we successfully imported two conversation. So let's go to review app and check that conversation. We need to go again to serving endpoints, and here in serving endpoint, we can find hidden open review app. And what's interesting here that we have chats to review, and we have these chats which can review. maybe it's not so clear here, but we can see what was sent, log, and the answer. So 500 is correct answer. So yes, we can provide more details and done. Second, chat to review is a bit more complicated because we can see here that we've just call the function. So this is the call to function get available x, and the parameter was pass chicken, but the output was also 500, so it's correct. So sometimes it's difficult because we are reviewing something which is in logs. So probably often more easier will be just using test the bot and ask question by ourselves. So again, how many chicken eggs do I have? And again, we have 500. So again, that response is good and correct. In real life, that human loop will be really important because you need to validate your LLM model, and these functions which are provided by Databricks are really important because you need to check all this conversation, especially when your model is in production, and validate is everything correct. So you need to validate that inputs, some input from user, and also make some test chats. So we can see that it's a great tool for developers and data scientists to validate output of the model. All information from him can be tracked and imported. So based on that, you can perform regular tests and keep human in the loop. Once again, to summarize everything, when we go to Playground, we have our model here. We can interact with that model and ask question. We can also always go to serving endpoint and start using various APIs to query that model, like REST API or Python library or SQL. Last thing which I would like to show you is that you can perform custom API calls. So for example, here when we click order 100x for Andrew for tomorrow, it is performing REST API call, and it can connect to external system to make some action. So basically to create something like this in SQL functions, you can include Python code. And in Python code, standard Python libraries and some more are included. So it's possible to perform API request and to include here any additional logic which you need. And it's really amazing because thanks to that integration of Python inside SQL function, you can really perform any action which you can imagine and deploy your own logic, which will be executed by LLM agents. I hope that you found that video useful, and it's really easy to start experimenting with deploying engines and experimenting with that. And it's really amazing that you can build whole model and whole system like this in Databricks. Thank you for watching, and see you on the next video.